All right, Biggie, we're back.
We're back here at the Mecca today on Be Built by Broser. We have Silvio once again. We haven't shown you shoulders yet, so we're going to do a SPEC shoulder workout with Silvio. So we're going to kill him pretty good and keep those shoulders growing for the show. And then, of course, we also have an Ask Merlin question at the end. So I hope you guys learned something and enjoy the show. Okay, guys, so the first exercise that we're using today is a seated shoulder press. We're doing it actually here on what is really an incline press machine, but instead we're facing into the machine, sitting a little bit more upright and making it into a shoulder press. The key here is that he's doing the negatives in 4 seconds. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And that he's not throwing the weight to the top, he's muscling it to the top using only the shoulders. As you can see, it's going to full lockout at the top, maybe just before the elbows completely lock out. But what he was trying to do is really trying to get a full contraction of the deltoids before he comes down all the way. This is pretty much focusing on the front of the shoulder, especially because we have a neutral grip where the palms are facing. This works the anterior deltoid very, very strongly, and it creates a little bit more of roundness around the front of the deltoid so that it separates really, really well for the chest. Give it a shot. Okay, guys, so the next movement that we're using here is a seated side lateral machine. Now, in the first exercise, we emphasize the negative portion of the rep over 4 seconds. Now we're switching things up and emphasizing the concentric or the positive portion of the rep. So basically what he's doing is he's trying to move the weight right from the beginning of the rep where his arms are down by his sides. He's not kicking it up at all. He's moving it really slow, inch by inch, all the way to the top in about 4 seconds. It takes a lot of discipline to do this because the body is pretty much programmed to try to move the weight as quickly as it can to make it easy. So by slowing it down all the way, you're actually getting a much harder contraction. You're getting more fiber activation. You're taking out any momentum or body English, and you're just forcing the muscles to work very, very hard. So this is another great way to hit any muscle group, but here we're working the lateral deltoids and we're trying to build more width into Silvio's body here. He's a shorter guy, so the wider we can make him up top, the smaller his waist is gonna look, the more flaring his thighs is gonna look, and we're giving him that X frame. Really, really tough to do these positives. Give it a try. Okay, for the next exercise, we're gonna go back to working the anterior deltoids. We're doing a cable front raise, facing away from the weight stack. He's leaning his torso forward just a little bit, which creates a little bit more tension at the top as if he was standing straight up. What he's doing is he's holding the top position for about 4 full seconds. So what we're doing is we're working the contracted position here, which really, really gives you a really tremendous burn. You can really, really feel the muscles working and really focus on that squeeze at the top by holding it for the full 4 seconds. You have to really stay strong and stay disciplined to hold that weight up at the top. He's controlling it all the way down to his thighs. He's coming right back to the top and he's trying to muscle it up. He's not throwing it up, he's muscling it up, just using the front of the shoulder. And again, holding that top position for 4 full seconds. It's a very, very tough way to do the movement. Holding the top position is very difficult. Give it a shot in your workouts. Okay, so we're finishing off the shoulder workout with a pretty unique lateral deltoid exercise. This is a incline side lateral. He's leaning back on an inclined bench set to about 55, 60 degrees or so. It's a very unique angle of pull from the bottom, so it hits the deltoids in a different way than the regular side laterals. Now what we're doing is we're emphasizing the stretch on the movement. You can't really see what he's doing, but what he is doing is when the dumbbells are down under the bench, he's actually trying to touch the dumbbells together under the bench. Obviously that's not gonna happen, but by squeezing the dumbbells together this way, he's gonna increase the stretch on the shoulder. So what we're doing is emphasizing the stretch. He's gonna hold that stretch at the bottom for about 3 to 4 seconds, put it under a deep stretch, and then he's gonna, with a controlled raise out to the sides, hitting the side deltoids. Now, it's very, very difficult. There's not a lot of movements that put a big stretch on the shoulders, but this one I discovered actually is really, really good for doing it. So give it a try in your workouts if you need more side deltoid development.
All right, Merlin, what do you got this week?
So I had somebody email me and they were asking about clenbuterol actually. And apparently they've never used it before. And they've done a lot of reading on the internet about how to use it. And they asked me, you know, what's the best way to use it when getting ready for a competition or whatever. So everybody knows, obviously, clenbuterol is actually an asthma drug, which has been shown to obviously burn body fat, also somewhat anti-catabolic. So many bodybuilders, fitness girls, bikini girls, a lot of people use it for fat loss. And there definitely is a lot of conflicting information on the internet about how to use it. And one of the reasons why a lot of the information is conflicting is because I don't think anybody knows exactly the best way to use it. Every guru out there pretty much has a different method of using it. But I don't think any of them have really been proven 100%. Some people recommend, you know, just using it every single day. Some people recommend using it for about 2 weeks until the body starts to get used to it and then switching to a two on, two off pattern. Some people go right into a two on, two off pattern. So I'm just going to tell you from my experience, and again, this is just a recommendation. I'm not prescribing anything or recommending that you do it. I just want to say that from my experience with people, the best way that I have found to use it that has produced the best results, and again, this is not scientifically proven, this has just come from my experience, is actually using it in a 5 day on, 2 day off pattern. So basically Monday through Friday with the weekends off, and doing that right from the beginning. Now, I always recommend that people start out with the lowest dosage possible, especially if it's somebody who's never used it before, because you know this is the type of medication that can cause rapid heartbeat and anxiety and things like that, which is something that you know you definitely don't want. If you have a heart condition or anything like that, you shouldn't be using it in the first place. But if you're healthy, you still should make sure to start off with a low dose. So for instance, for the first week, maybe Monday through Friday, you take 20 micrograms a day, Monday through Friday. You take the weekend completely off. If everything goes well, the following week you can go to 40 micrograms a day, Monday through Friday, again, take the weekend off. And then you can raise the dose each week till you would get, some people go really crazy high dosages like 140, 180, 200 micrograms. I don't recommend anything over 100 micrograms a day. I think that's enough. So you can work your way up to 100 micrograms, stay at 100 micrograms as long as you're still feeling good, not having rapid heartbeats or any side effects that are causing major problems for you. And then I also do recommend coming off of it slowly. So basically tapering back down from 100, maybe down to about 60 for a week, and then maybe 40, and then maybe 20, and then go off completely. So this is the way I've used it with the competitors that I've worked with. It's always worked well. It doesn't seem to cause any side effects, and it doesn't seem to stop working at any point in the cycle. So it's something that you can give a try. Again, this is just my recommendation, my experience. You are going to find a lot of conflicting information, but at least it's a good way to start and give you a protocol for your first show.
Awesome. Thanks, Mickey.